Well, if you buy one of our portable Moxons from Very Super Cool Tools, this is how it will arrive. It will arrive just ready to assemble. All the bushings will have been put in place. The fortifying bolts and everything are in place. The bushings have all been put in, chamfered, and these front ones reamed out to make sure everything's going to go really well. And you'll see that the way the thing will always go together in the orientation where the writing mates up on the bottom. So this is upside down. So it says Very Super Cool Tools, and then this is the number of Moxon that I made. So that's the sixth one that I made. And as you can see, I've got a whole bunch of them that are ready to ship out. So I want to just set this one up right now on the edge of my bench and just show you how easy it is to take it out of the box and get to work with it. Now I don't want to damage the finish with my clamps and stuff, so I'm going to use some pads. So these all have a minimum of 3 coats of oil-based Sutherland Wells finish on it, and it's pretty built, you know. But you know, this is not a, I did not go crazy like this is a furniture finish. These are vices that are going to get beat up and dinged. So you can always tell that the front is the section that has the bolt heads, not the nuts. So let me just slip a block up underneath here. Like I said, I don't want to damage someone else's property. So someone that buys this, I want them to get it as clean as possible. And you know, just this easy, you can immobilize this, and it isn't going anywhere. Are completely out of your way. The overall length of this this unit is about 33 inches. Yes, skosh under 33 inches, and you have a free and clear 18 inches in between the screws. It's actually a little bit more, but these are the 18 inch models that I made here. So then the next thing you need to do is just take the piece of the two pieces of Acme thread, and you just put one here and one here. And you know, after you get this, you should, you know, make sure you always keep these good and oiled. And then you put a lock collar on the inside, pass it through, and a lock collar on this one. It through. Now you're going to determine where you want your capacity. So let's just go ahead and set this out at maximum capacity right now, so you can get a feel for how much capacity this really has. And the beauty of this design is, if you don't want this capacity, well then you just shove the Acme thread in the back where it's out of your way, and you only have the capacity on the front with just enough thread coming out to do the work that you're doing. So if you're cutting dovetails on 4/4 stock, you don't need to have it like this. You bring it back, lock it back in place here. So a big washer and an Acme threaded nut goes on the back. And you just bring that up, bring the collar up. And this does not have to be, you do not have to put a death grip on any of this stuff. It just has to be snugged down. The collar just needs to be snugged down nicely. You know, I recommend you get a ball driver this size, or a T-handle ball driver if you're going to do this. But I have these setups here that I use all the time, so I'm not gonna. I have these socket extension ball drivers, is what I'm saying, and then I just have an adapter here that goes into my hex drive. So there's that on there. So you have an adjustable wrench, and like I said, you don't need to crank this down. Just one slight snug turn is all it needs. All you're asking this to do is to not spin when you spin your handles on, and now it can't spin. That's all you're asking this to do. So you know that the writing is down where I showed you before, number 6, and the part of the Very Super Cool Tools logo. You can also tell that I rounded it over, softened the outside edges of this, and left it crisper on the inside. So you just slip it over the Acme thread. So this is pretty much maximum capacity right here. You know, somewhere in the 10-inch range, you know. This is 10 3/16. So you got a lot of, I mean, you can get drawers down in here, you can hold jewelry boxes, all kinds of things that have always been really difficult to manipulate. And you just can change it and lock it and away you go. And the second you don't want it out here with this kind of capacity, well, you just simply loosen your lock collars on the inside. And get it to the capacity that you want. Say you're wanting to work on some 6/4 material right in here. So then you have to take a couple minutes to thread the nuts back down on. But it's not as though you're going to be doing this every 5 minutes. You're going to get a setup going, and that's going to be what you're going to use for the better part of while you're doing an operation over and over again. It's not as though you're changing and doing this every 5 minutes. And you've got, everything has the bronze bushings. This Acme thread is aligned by 2 bronze bushings. This has a bronze bushing, this has a bronze bushing. So there's not anything to wear out, you know, like having a wood writing over steel. That is just, in my opinion, just unacceptable. I can't have that. I can't have a wood mechanism like that. So here you go. Now you're ready to get busy with, you know, some other work. And you know, I don't put leather on the inside. You're certainly welcome to put leather on the inside. You could always just have some leather or some fabric that you draped over this, but I think leather ends up getting glue and embedded particles in it and stuff, so I'm not a big fan of it, but you're certainly welcome to do it. If you build your own, like I've said before, I really highly recommend you properly finish everything before you attach leather. Don't attach leather just to bare wood. You really need to seal everything up from the atmosphere before you attach anything to it. Plus, it'll contact cement or however you put it on is going to bond much better to a finish than it will to bare wood, because the finish penetrates deep down into the wood fibers and really gives the contact cement something to grab onto. But yeah, you're welcome to do that. It's your thing. You can do whatever you like. But see, this is nice because now you've got something where you can work around it. You don't have this hip catcher to interfere with when you're moving and operating around the workbench. But whenever you need it, you've got the capacity with these 18-inch long Acme threads to just bring them out and really hold some things that are always trouble to hold, like drawers and boxes and unusual components. Well, let me just go ahead and show you this thing, just how easy it is to put something in here I'm always real hesitant to use something that I'm going to sell as new, you know, furniture or whatever. But I mean, when you tighten this guy down, you don't even have to crank it that hard because you have, you know, all that rotational torque there. But this thing just grabs onto stuff, and I've used my double Moxon on my Ribot for a couple months now, and I'm just using it like crazy. And I just have the wood to wood jaws, and I have never seen one bit of slip. And you can, you know, I've been also just doing this where if I want to release this, I just take a stick and I'll just release it here just so I can, don't tear up my hands. So that's a pretty nice feature. But it's a great setup, and I've woodworked for almost 30 years and have never had a Moxon Vise until the last couple months, and now I'm like, how in the heck did I ever live without one? Because what the way they hold panels, drawers, boxes is like nothing else. I mean, not a Ribot style vise holds it in the same way, so it really is a great thing. And most people already have a workbench, and so to try to integrate a Moxon into an existing workbench is tough, but here you've got now a portable setup that you can clamp on to any edge of a work table or a workbench, or even you could build a sawhorse that this could sit on, and have it to where you could just put it on a sawhorse, and when you didn't want to use this, you could just hang it up on the wall. But it's a beast. This thing is a beast. It will take all comers when it comes to holding stock. And the capacity that you have is, you know, I've never seen a Moxon that has this kind of capacity. So you've really got a lot of capabilities to just get on with your work. Okay, I'm ready to get into full Moxon production here. I've got a bunch of white oak. I'm going to make one out of hard maple because I have some left over from those prototypes. And I've made my templates. These are going to be 18-inch Moxons. That means there's going to be a free and clear 18 inches.